Okay, so let's get into how to do this. Subtitle is what I would recommend, and that's the default. That's why I say you can just hit okay, and that's fine. So I'm gonna hit okay. And what this did, in addition to audio and video, we have a caption track now, but you can always, zoom in. I'm using the option key on the keyboard and just the scroll wheel to make this bigger.
Can you adjust these captions clips in your timeline just like you would any other clip?
Oh, most definitely.
Do all the same like keyboard shortcuts like Q and W work on that?
Yeah, they do, but you have to be careful with Q and W, because you're going to be cutting other stuff as well.
Yeah, any of your active tracks.
Exactly. Yeah. So the keyboard shortcut actually that I use quite a lot is the E key, which is snap to playhead. So I've got this endpoint selected, and if I just hit E, it's going to snap it to wherever my playhead is.
Oh my God, I didn't know that one.
Oh, it's my favorite. Well, I've got so many favorite keyboard shortcuts, but that's one of them. So I got the first one done. Now we've got options for how to create the second one. Obviously, I could just, repeat the exact same action of, hitting the plus button. But since we're talking about keyboard shortcuts, there is actually a keyboard shortcut. Go to the Premiere Pro menu, open up keyboard shortcuts, and then you can search for, what you're looking for. So I'm going to search for caption. And so you can see that we've got some default keyboard shortcuts. Now these, option command C might be a bit of a Vulcan death grip. You can totally change this to something else. So I'm going to do option command C, which drops a caption item on my timeline. Let's talk about some other things in the text panel that are super, super helpful. I've only got 6 captions here, but if you've got 100 captions, isn't it nice to be able to search for things and find them? So like, let's say I'm looking for time. It's going to highlight every instance of the word time. This is also really useful for doing, replacing things. So like, let's say that I misspelled the word time and time again, and I can replace it to the proper spelling of the word time and replace it throughout my entire transcript. Okay, sweet. So we're actually in pretty good shape here. The next thing I want to do is export this thing, right?
Great.
So I'm just going to choose, the regular export media, and then go down and find the captions tab here. And this is the default option, which is burn captions in the video. So burning it in means that they'll be permanently included in the video image, and you can never turn them off again because they're there forever. With a sidecar file, now you see that the captions went away in my preview. This is going to export basically a text file that you can then use in conjunction with that clean export. And let me show you how that works. I recommend using the subrip subtitle format, SRT for short.
Okay.
And you don't need to check anything else. Don't worry about this include SRT styling. That's kind of more for advanced use cases. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go ahead and export. And remember that I chose the sidecar method. So when I open up the video, it's not going to have captions burned in. But if I open this SRT file, I'm actually just going to open this with, let's open it with text edit. This is, the time code from, time code start to time code end. And then what is the text?
Nice.
So if you were going to go upload this project exactly to YouTube, then you'd upload the video. And then once that's uploaded, you can go into, their system there and add this SRT. And then your viewers are going to be able to turn those captions on and off. There's another benefit to doing it this way, which is that, YouTube will offer Google Translate. So people who don't speak your language will, with varying degrees of success, sometimes the Google Translate is a little funny, but it can be good enough to get the idea across. And also search results are going to potentially get hits based on the text in your captions. So it means that your video is then more search engine optimized, which is cool.